thank you for joining us on Data Cloud Now, where we bring you the latest in all things data in business and industry. I'm now joined by Navindra Yadav, co-founder and CEO at Theom. Navindra, welcome to the program.
Thank you, Ryan, for having me here.
To start with, what are the top three data access gov challenges you are addressing with your customers, Navindra?
Wow. So Theom actually helps customers with data access governance and data security, like exfiltration and so on and so forth. So this is the first part about data access governance. Things that we've actually gone and solved. The first one is all around principle of least privilege, enforcing that with the data. So it's an AI system that automatically discovers who has access to what data, should they have access to that data, and automatically sets the right configurations inside Snowflake and whatever data store we're using. That's one. The other area is all around contract governance, data sharing, data exchanges, data domains, and data meshes. Like, what data is moving between different domains? Should it be moving there? Ensuring that the contracts are adhered to.
Great to hear. Thank you so much for the baseline. You know, at Theom, as you just mentioned, you detect active data breaches and protect your clients' businesses. From a macro standpoint, are you noticing any trends?
Oh, absolutely. And the one that surprised me the most is service accounts that have access to data. And service accounts are applications and other things, machine users that have access to the data and their abuse. So what do I mean by that? We see things like service accounts where there are mostly 100,000 sessions going into Snowflake. There's one session that's a human being masquerading as a service account who's taken some credentials out of Vault and then accessing the data and doing things differently. Theom finds these instances and says, that's a machine that's good. It's accessing data correctly and so on and so forth. We behavior profiled accesses. And in some cases, you find that odd human being accessing data and nail that down. Another trend that we have started picking it up is abuse of data through AI systems. So people getting in through AI systems like inference engines or RAG systems, retrieval augmented generation, and accessing data using those systems. And again, it's one of those service accounts accessing data cases.
You know, I want to dive into the details a little bit. What verticals are you deployed in, and what's the business value return to your customers?
So big ones for us are financials. Financials have a lot of data that they exchange with different things, so it's not a surprise. Another vertical is healthcare. Healthcare is another vertical where there's a lot of Snowflake presence, and they are big consumers of data platforms. Airlines is the third one that we're present in, and big tech. So these are the four verticals that we're right now moving in, and we are expanding. We're a startup, 2 years plus going in. And in terms of value that we've delivered back to our customers is around the three M's. I always try to measure things back to the three M's. How much money have we generated for these companies? Like, how much have we improved their top line? How much brand, have we improved their brand things? So market share, for example, that's another M. And the third one is around, have we saved them time and money, the minutes things? How many minutes have we saved? So Theom always measures things back into these three categories back to our customers.
I love that. The three M's. You know, diving in a little bit deeper into Theom collectively, what's unique about your deployment overall, Navindra?
So first thing is, Theom runs inside Snowflake, inside the customer's own jurisdiction. So no data leaves their environment. That's a big thing. If you look at the three verticals that I, three of the four verticals I talked about, financials, healthcare, airlines, all of them highly regulated industries. For them, you can't take data out of their environment and take it to your cloud and process it, because who owns that data? What happens with the jurisdiction and control? So Theom runs inside the customer's environment and delivers all of its outcomes there. So that's big. Snowflake has helped us a lot in that. The architecture beautifully lends it to deliver this outcome. Second thing is around 15 minutes to deploy. Theom comes as an app on Snowflake, 15 minutes to deploy, and results start rolling out for customers. So that's really unique about Theom. And using AI inside this environment to discover everything about the customer's own environment running in their own systems. So those are our three USPs.
I know we've covered a lot.
Yeah.
Top of mind for executives across the board is Gen AI and LLMs. Now I want to look towards the future. What role do you see Gen AI having in threat detection?
So That's a great question. I hear that often from multiple of our customers, Gen AI for threat detection. The easy low-hanging fruit is constructing a system where your queries can be expressed in natural language and you can find threats in your environment. That's the base case things. Multiple companies, CrowdStrike and others, are trying to go down in that direction. Where Theom has taken this whole thing much further is run your LM. So a threat detection system can be expressed in language. There's a grammar for it. You can actually say these are the sequence of steps that must happen for this attack to become successful. So Theom actually looks at this problem from a language model point of view and stitches these things together and then automatically detects attacks in this. This is a really sophisticated way of using Gen AI for threat detection. And we're the first proof point, as far as I know, the first company that's solved the problem using threat detection in this way.
It's an exciting next chapter. We're currently in Santa Clara at the final stop of the Data Cloud World Tour. The buzz, the excitement is all around us. How does the Data Cloud take the complexity out of the equation for your clients?
There are multiple use cases that a Data Cloud has gone and solved things around this. One example, let me just pick a simple example, data sharing, data exchanges, data monetization. So that's in the old days when data sharing was done, if I just go back like just two decades is not too long, people were using FTP, file transfer protocol, to transfer data between different systems. Then came along APIs. People started building APIs to transfer data, but the problem with classic APIs is volume of data transfers. Then people went into ETL jobs, started creating ETL pipelines, connecting different things together, but they break down. Data, actually, you lose jurisdiction over your data. There's no data security. All these issues were present. Then comes along Snowflake with data exchanges and data sharing, where the same data can be accessed by multiple people across different domains inside your company, outside your company, doesn't matter, And it's the same copy of the data. Governance gets attached to it, so it's securely moved, and across multiple different cloud providers. You're not stuck to one cloud provider, one region. You can get data anywhere in the world. That's really exciting. That's what's made Theom. Now Theom sits on top of that and starts telling, does data access governance? Are you in compliance with your own data contracts that you have with your upstream providers or with your downstream providers and things like that? There's new markets that are being opened up. Data exchanges are becoming more popular. Data marketplaces are coming up. Back in the day, 5 to 10 years ago, people weren't talking about data marketplaces. Everyone was talking about app marketplaces. But in my opinion, data marketplaces is going to be even bigger than app marketplaces. Thanks.
Well, looking forward to seeing what's next for Theom. Thank you so much for joining
me. Thank you, Ryan. This is fantastic talking to you.
And for the audience watching, I'm Ryan Green with Data Cloud Now. I'll see you soon.